evening. Sorry, but could you please remain standing as we have our invocation? Shall we pray? Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for blessing us to come into this place, oh God, as we cheer on the final three contestants in the Miss Tuskegee University pageant, oh God. We pray that you bless Nyree. We pray that you bless Sharkiri. We pray that you bless Sierra on today and give them the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding to say all they need to say to these judges as they complete the task of running for Miss Tuskegee University. Bless this ceremony and everyone in it, oh God. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Now we will have a presentation of Mr. TU and gentlemen. Please give these gentlemen a round of applause as they come to the stage. Second gentleman, Dominique Crum, junior hospitality management major from Mobile, Alabama. First gentleman, Brandon Fennell, senior architecture major from Laconia, Georgia. And Mr. Tuskegee University, Maurice Evans III, mechanical engineering major, business administration minor from Atlanta, Georgia. Let's give it up for them.
Good evening, and welcome to the 2015 Miss Tuskegee University pageant. I am Shaniqua Bianca Jones, second attendant to Miss Tuskegee University, and I have the pleasure of introducing our mistress of ceremony. Miss Randy LaRae Harrison, a native of Spartanburg, South Carolina, had the distinct honor of serving as the 84th Miss Tuskegee University. As a firm believer in God, Randy leads her life on the words of Romans 12, verse 2. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. Randy ran on the campaign slogan, The Dash, inspired by Linda Ellis' poem, The Dash. Throughout her campaign, her platform highlighted issues of health and wellness and an overall encouragement to the student body to pay it forward in both the university and the community. Randy is currently a master's student at Columbia University Teachers College in New York City, pursuing a master's of art in curriculum and teaching, and researching how students' morale and motivation influences their scholastic achievement and literacy. She works as a student ambassador as well, has been featured in various Columbia University publications, and most recently was in the 2015 Teachers College Annual Report. Additionally, she recently was invited to speak on the Board of Trustees about the importance of scholarships at an executive event for Teachers College Capital Campaign. Randy was selected as one of three recipients of the HBCU Diversity in Education Full Tuition Scholarship. It is her unwavering belief that in order to create sustainable change, you must be a platform to the African American community and strategically infiltrate the institutionalized structures of our society that works towards dismantling the community. In her leisure, Randy finds pleasure in traveling, finding unique restaurants, reading, writing, exercising, spending quality time with friends and family, participating in community service projects. Randy is the proud daughter of Charlton Williams and Rayfield Harrison, and has two sisters, Tanya Martin and Aaliyah Patton. Please help me in welcoming Miss Randy LaRae Harrison.
Thank you, Bianca, for that warm welcome. Good evening, Tuskegee University. Sorry. It feels good to be at my alma mater, which is my home. I am honored to guide you all through the process in introducing the 86th Miss Tuskegee University. This evening will be full of elegance, poise, glamour, sophistication, and beauty. Let's begin the night with a greeting from April Baldwin.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am April Nicole Baldwin, a senior history major from Birmingham, Alabama, and I serve as your first attendant to Miss Tuskegee University. I send you greetings for tonight's presentation of elegance. These young ladies have worked diligently throughout their campaigns to show the student body why they are capable of representing the students, alumni, community, and the brand of Tuskegee University. However, I would be remiss if I did not acknowledge their campaign managers, teams, and the students who saw the Miss Tuskegee it factor in each of these candidates and chose to cast their vote for them. Thank you for your dedication, your faith, and voice on who you want to be your next Miss Tuskegee University. On behalf of the Royal Court, I greet all students, alumni, administration, community members, family, and friends. May you all enjoy this marvelous evening and enjoy the presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, April, for greeting our very special guest. We must also acknowledge the parents and guardians of tonight's candidates. You all have committed your time, financial support, and love to the candidates. And we see the characteristics of your positive influences in these young ladies' lives. Now, it is time to introduce the three candidates for Miss Tuskegee University. Ladies and gentlemen, here is the introduction of candidates.
Vowing to become your illustrious 86th Miss Tuskegee University. And this evening, I will be your contestant number one. Our distinctive vision and purpose can only be fulfilled through total restoration. Greetings, I am Sharkeria Simone Evans, a third year aerospace science engineering major from Greenville, Mississippi, and I'm standing strongly on a platform of RSVP, Restoring Ski's Vision and Purpose. And tonight, I am your contestant number two.
A junior sales and marketing major from the historic Tuskegee, Alabama, and I am running on the bold platform of unleashing our inner gladiator. This afternoon, I am your contestant number three. Captivating presentation, ladies. Ladies and gentlemen, please give these contestants another round of applause. At this time, we will have Dr. Cynthia Sellers-Simon, the Vice President of Student Affairs and Enrollment Management, to introduce our esteemed judges.
Good evening. It is indeed a pleasure to have the opportunity to introduce our judges for the 2015 Miss Tuskegee University pageant. Miss Crystal Hawkins. Miss Hawkins is a native of St. Louis, Missouri, and is a public relations specialist at Hyundai Motor Manufacturing, located in Montgomery, Alabama. She leads Hyundai's community outreach activities by working closely with nonprofit organizations throughout the river region. Pageants are not new to Ms. Hawkins. During her high school years in a small town in Tennessee, she competed to represent the city, and out of 50 contestants, she won every category, from swimsuit to talent. She became the first African-American to win. A few years later, Crystal competed in Miss Black Tennessee pageant. She won many of the pageant's categories and finished second runner-up. Miss Hawkins was also Miss Black and Gold at Tennessee State University. She has also served as a judge at numerous pageants. Crystal is also an actress. You may have seen her featured in numerous commercials with Adams Drugs, East Chase Mall, the Montgomery Zoo, First Community Bank, and even Hyundai's Super Bowl commercials. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in giving Ms. Crystal Hawkins a round of applause as we welcome her to Tuskegee University. Mr. Nicholas Sturdivant. Mr. Sturdivant is a resident of Selma, Alabama, by way of Long Beach, California. He is a product of the Selma City School System and alumnus of Selma High School. He graduated from Concordia College, receiving a business administration degree with special emphasis in sports management. He currently serves as the Director of Facilities at Concordia College, as well as the voice of the Concordia College Hornet basketball team. Mr. Sturdivant is a mentor to many young men and women throughout the Concordia College family. He has served in many categories, capacities, working with pageants, programs, and activities in student life and development. Mr. Sturdivant stands firm on the idea that a person who enjoys life is an enjoyable person. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Nicholas Sturdivant to our campus. Ms. Lynetta Banks. Ms. Lynetta Banks is a native of Rochester, New York. She's the president of Lynetta Banks Group, a professional development training company. Ms. Banks is a dynamic speaker and a powerful coach with a gift for developing leaders to strategize and accomplish their goals. She is now the newest talk show host on WBIH Montgomery's Blab TV. A former Air Force captain, Ms. Banks was the first African American from Rochester, New York to graduate from the U.S. Air Force Academy. She holds a BS degree in behavioral science, psychology, a Master of Science in Human Services and Diversity Studies, and is a PhD candidate at Capella University. She's a member of many community organizations. Her active involvement in the community earned her recognition as Montgomery's top 30 women of influence and a nomination for Montgomery's Young Professional of the Year. Ms. Banks is a former dance instructor and model and has judged numerous pageants, dance, speech competitions. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give Ms. Banks a warm welcome to Tuskegee University. Mr. Joe Howard, Jr. Mr. Howard is a Montgomery native and sole proprietor of Results Media Consulting. He is also the owner of the House of Suave, a modeling group, and is the host of the most attended fashion expos each year. Mr. Howard is also a former model. He's a graduate of Troy University, where he received the Bachelor of Science in Business Management. Mr. Howard is an activist of community outreach. He volunteers with numerous nonprofit organizations. Additionally, Mr. Howard is an advocate of health and wellness and has received numerous awards. He has numerous years of experience in judging and serving as a judge for pageants. We are very happy to have Mr. Joe Howard with us this evening, so please join me in giving him a round of applause. And Ms. Krista Bell. Ms. Bell is a native of Roanoke, Alabama. She is an honor graduate from Jacksonville State University, where she received a Bachelor of Arts in Political Science and a double minor in Spanish Business and Technical Writing. She is also a 2011 graduate of Auburn University at Montgomery, where she received a Master of Public Administration with a concentration in nonprofit management and leadership. Crystal currently resides in Montgomery. She's employed by the Alabama League, a volunteer association of cities and towns in Alabama, where she serves as Assistant Director of Member Services. She has several years of pageant experience in the areas of competition, judging, directing, and coaching. Ms. Bell enjoys singing, reading, writing, public speaking, running, and modeling. She is the current Miss Montgomery United States 2005. Please join me in welcoming Ms. Bell to Tuskegee University. Our official timekeeper for this evening's event is our own Quinn Desmond Caleb. He's a senior psychology major. From Opelika, Alabama. This is his fifth year on the Elections Committee. and his first year as an official timekeeper. Let's give Quinn Desmond another round of applause. At this time, we will recognize all relatives and friends of our three contestants. So all relatives, family members of our contestants, please stand to be recognized. Okay, if there are former students who served as Miss Tuskegee University or attendants to Miss Tuskegee University, please stand. If there are former students who served as Mr. Tuskegee University, our gentlemen to Mr. Tuskegee University, please stand. Thank you so very much, and please enjoy the evening.
Thank you, Dr. Seller Simon, and welcome to Tuskegee University judges and special guests. Now we will have Malik Kendricks, Student Government Association President for the 2015-2016 academic school year.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Malik Kendricks, a junior political science major from Las Vegas, Nevada, and I will be serving as the 2015-2016 Student Government Association President. I welcome you to this joyous occasion as we celebrate the ending of the reign for the 85th Miss Tuskegee University and introduce the 86th Miss Tuskegee University and Court. As the newly elected Student Government Association President, I will work closely with the next Miss Tuskegee University to establish a one-of-a-kind relationship with the students here on campus. Our campus is a family-oriented community that makes all of our visitors feel welcome and at home. On behalf of the student body, we welcome you with open arms to Tuskegee University. I wish all the lovely candidates the best of luck, and I hope that you all enjoy this pageant. Thank you.
Thank you, Malik, for welcoming our guests and current families. Now it is time for the candidates to present their business attire and oratorical presentation. The theme for this year is Remember the Time, Tuskegee University Women Maintaining the Tuskegee University Legacy. Each candidate was asked to answer the following question. In today's society, what characteristics and attributes have you noticed in the world that would embody an ideal Tuskegee woman? And we are ready for contestant number one. She is wearing a black and white two-piece halo suit. This look is completed with a basic black pointy toe pump with pearls adorning her ears. She's ready for a meeting on Wall Street or an interview with 3M. Contestant number one.
When asked the question, what characteristics and attributes have I noted in the world today that embodies an ideal Tuskegee woman, I simply state, a Tuskegee woman's qualities are vast. She seeks knowledge first and exuberates class. She is purpose-driven and not afraid to lead. Service is her motto, for these are her seeds. A Tuskegee woman has been embodied in me. For a Tuskegee woman is what you see. She understands the platform, same script, different cast. You see, the script is our legacy, but it only provides the blueprint. It is up to us, the cast, to not only fulfill but supersede the legacy that has been provided. Dr. Booker T. Washington provided this legacy in 1881 when he taught his first class of 30 adults in a one-room shanty. This is our script. In 2012, Tuskegee University was named one of the top baccalaureate programs in the United States of America. Yes, we are the cast. We are the modern-day Martin Luther Kings, Rosa Parks, Malcolm X's, and Maya Angelou's. So let us strive daily for excellence so that Tuskegee University can counter stereotypes, societal ignorance, and academic apathy. Let us confirm our dedication to this institution known as the pride of the Swift Growing South, the originator of Ball and Parlay, the Crimson and Old Gold Fortress, our beloved mother Tuskegee. Tuskegee University, the time is ours. Life is a stage and it is time for a show. It is our showtime at the Apollo. For the script, it has been written. We are just a different cast. I am Nyree French, vowing to become your 86th Miss Tuskegee University. Thank you. Number two. Sharkiria is stepping on the scene with her patterned green and black pencil skirt. Her black blazer and black camisole completes her business look. She also has black heels to match. And let's not forget, she's always wearing that radiant smile. Contestant number two.
There's a woman who always keeps her head held high. Her eyes sparkle like the bright stars in the sky. Her smile shines beautifully like the sun rising over the horizon. And her intelligence, wisdom, and hard work are not surprising. When I think of a woman, a real woman, I think of a lady with poise, elegance, and grace. This is the ideal Tuskegee University woman. Not very long ago, I, Sharkiria Simone Evans, a little old native from Mississippi, wanted to be groomed into the perfect epitome of a Tuskegee woman. I wanted to truly understand where her ambition came from. So I did what every little studious nerd would do, and I did my research. I discovered that a Tuskegee woman has self-worth, trustworthiness, humbleness, vision and purpose. That is why I decided to stand strongly on the platform of RSVP, Restoring Skiggy's Vision and Purpose. I wanted to uphold those characteristics and attributes of that woman who stands tall with courage. Our legacy at our university has been carried out through the brilliance of our very first Miss Tuskegee University, Dorothy Gray, to our current Tequila Celestin. These women showed their love for Tuskegee, both near and far. So I stand before you on today, delivering the ideas of a cherished woman. And I will continue to proclaim that a true Tuskegee University woman stands distinctively to serve through humble vision and purpose. Thank you.
Contestant number two. We will now have
number 3. Contestant number 3 is wearing a stylishly tailored ivory suit. It is fit for business as her inner gladiator is ready to fix the situation. She complements it with a pair of nude heels and jewelry. She is ready for a meeting with the president anytime. This ensemble is gracing her frame.
A Tuskegee woman is a woman who is poised, educated, and prepared to make a difference. She has a well-rounded accumulation of knowledge, skills, and abilities. But what really sets her apart from the crowd is her strength. Strength is a characteristic that embodies the ideal Tuskegee woman. She has the strength to stand up for what she believes in, the strength not to settle for the glass ceiling, and the strength to stand up for those without a voice. A Tuskegee woman has strength of character. She has decided what her motivation is, and she strives to make a positive difference for herself, those she loves, and the community at large. She is not easily deterred, and obstacles serve as motivators, energizing her towards success. A Tuskegee woman has strength of will. She does not accept falsely imposed limits on her ability to succeed. Her strength serves as motivation, energy, and determination to accomplish her goals. And lastly, a Tuskegee woman has the strength to unleash her inner gladiator, meaning she will fight for what she believes in and encourage others to do the same. A Tuskegee woman is a TU gladiator. She fights to make Tuskegee University the best it can be while also challenging herself to make sure that she is the best she can be. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, your contestant number 3. Thank you, ladies, for those profound speeches. It is imperative that Miss Tuskegee University speaks well, for she is frequently asked to make speeches throughout the school year. I am confident that these young ladies will have no problem with that in the future. Now we will have the Tuskegee University Men's Glee Club and the Tuskegee University Women's Glee Club here to perform a selection. Please give them a round of applause.
Make that change.
Ladies and gentlemen, give them a round of applause one more time. Awesome. They never cease to amaze me. That was a remarkable rendition of that song. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please prepare yourselves for the casual presentation of the candidates. Each contestant was asked to model their best outfit that can be seen throughout the upcoming school year. And here are their presentations. First, contestant number one. Contestant number one is wearing a pink loose-fitting shirt with a basic pair of white jeans. To finish, this look, she's added a nude pump, and this casual look is perfect for a stroll at the park or at a patio lunch with some friends. Ladies and gentlemen, your contestant number one. Now we will have contestant number two. Contestant number two is Shakira, and she is sporting her white sheer lace top with her fun and flirty tutu skirt. Her sweet and simple nude heels completes her outfit. But let us not forget, she is always wearing that radiant smile. Ladies and gentlemen, your contestant number two. We'll have your contestant number three. Contestant number three, feminine, poised, and ready to serve. Contestant number three is wearing a red, white, and black fit and flare dress. It is fun, yet appropriate. Appropriate for class in the Andrew Grimmer Business House. The color blocking of the ensemble shows that she is bold, organized, and a force to be reckoned with. Her red heels complete the look and shows that she is a firm place among her peers. With this look, she embodies what Miss Tuskegee University exemplifies all day. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number three. Ladies and gentlemen, can we take just a moment to give every contestant a round of applause? These ladies definitely know how to dress for the occasion. Their bubbly personalities sure caught my attention. Just like the 85th Miss Tuskegee University, Tequila Celestin. Throughout her reign, Miss Celestin has had some trials and tribulations, as we all have had. But through it all, she has learned valuable life lessons that have developed her character and maturity. We will now have a royal review of her year as Miss Tuskegee University.
Hello, my name is Tequila Celestin. I'm a senior social work major from Los Angeles, California, and I am the 85th Miss Tuskegee University for the 2014-2015 school year. How hard was the campaign? It wasn't hard at all. It was actually really fun. When I ran for Miss Tuskegee University, I had a lot of support. My campaign team was amazing. My campaign manager, Ashley Hicks, Nikki Golashi, they did amazing. So it was really fun for me just to get to know students and to interact with them and to allow them to show them why I should represent the school for them was really fun.
What was the hardest thing during that one? You just said it was easy, so I guess there's no.
Yeah. I mean, there were some challenges that I had. I know there were times when I felt like, you know, I was by myself. I'm from Los Angeles, like I said, so all the other candidates, they had their parents with them at times during the chat and shoot and everything. So when I didn't have my family there, it was, you know, sometimes it was lonely, but I did have my campaign team and my friends to help me, you know, make me warm inside. Yeah, so. It was very interesting. I was a character. I remember just jumping up and down, thanking God, praising God that I won. It was really surreal to me, honestly. I saw my mom was crying, my grandmother. So just to see that I made an accomplishment that my family and my school could be proud of, it was just really surreal. I was like,
that's good.
Ooh, it was most definitely homecoming. I love alumni so much, so very much. They're very warm, giving, and they're the reason why I stay at Tuskegee University, and I'm so proud of Tuskegee University. If it wasn't for the alumni, I don't think I would be here. So it was definitely coming back home or having alumni come home to see me and to see their finished product, especially the Los Angeles Tuskegee alumni. They helped me. They helped me grow here at Tuskegee. So to give that back to them during homecoming was definitely my favorite part of my reign. Oh my gosh!
So how was that campaign?
Oh, it was hard. It was hard because I campaigned right after I won Miss Tuskegee University. So the day of the pageant, this time last year, it was like the next day. So it was really hard to like really get on track. And usually, Miss Tuskegee, she's in the top four. Like, you know, when they're in voting, she's like the top four school that has the most votes. So this year, I wasn't able to be in the top four until like the very last week of my campaign. So I was nervous. I was scared. I didn't think I was gonna make it. But I'm glad that my school, the alumni, pushed through, my friends, they came through and started voting for me. And you really got to see like the support and the love that Tuskegee University has for each other. Like, when I say Tuskegee is a family-oriented place, it really is, and I definitely saw that during my campaign trip. At times it was, and I say that because you can't please everybody. And I know for myself, I love to please everyone. Like, I don't want anyone to be upset. It's uncomfortable for me when people are upset. So to be in a position where one person thinks or a group of people think you should be one way and then another group of people think you should be another way, it was hard at times to really balance, you know, what Miss Tuskegee is, who Miss Tuskegee is, and then who I am. But what I did realize was I can't let the position make me. I have to make the position and then uphold the position in highest standards according to what my morals and values are. And that is what a Miss Tuskegee is and what a Tuskegee woman is. So what I did to overcome that was just, you know, be myself. You know, there was a reason why students voted for me and trusted me to represent them. It was through my personal morals and my personal upbringing and personality. So I had to just maintain. College, I definitely want to go to grad school. I preferably go to the University of Michigan and get my social work, master's in social work. I also want to join the Peace Corps. I want to be able to travel to Africa and help with community development. And then after that, I want to own my own nonprofit organization to help counsel individuals in the Black community, children and families specifically in the Black community. Bittersweet. On one hand, I'm like, yes, there's somebody else that's about to get this opportunity and they're gonna have so much fun. But then on the opposite end, it's like, wow, it's really ending. Like all that whole process. Just, you know, life is a process, and to see, you know, the process begin and end is bittersweet. The advice of to thine own self be true. That was one of the quotes that one of my acting coaches back home used to say all the time, to thine own self be true. And that just means stay true to yourself. Be who you are. Don't let anyone influence you to be anything else. Live your reign like you want to, you know. Of course people are gonna say things, of course people are gonna do things, but be prepared to just, you know, just live your life and live your reign like you want to. That's all you can do.
To Keyless, April, and Bianca, I just wanted to say you all have been a phenomenal core. Can we give them a round of applause? Oh, the places we'll go and the memories we'll make. It was like yesterday when I gave my crown to a deserving queen, and now I've watched Tequila's grow. I'm not gonna tear, but I've noticed that she's made incredible progress throughout the year. It's been fun to follow her on Instagram and everyone, actually. Now it is her time to continue the legacy of Miss Tuskegee University and pass the torch to one of these ladies tonight. The young contestants have worked diligently this past week to perform and perfect their talents for you all. Being able to have the courage and the gumption is enough to consider a talent, in my opinion. But now they will present a series of performing arts in singing, dancing, and spoken word. We will now have contestant number one.
To have a cultural impact. I want to be an inspiration, to leave a legacy, to show others what can be done.
I want to leave my footprints on the sands of time. Know there was something that I left behind.
Now we will have your contestant number two. Number three.
students, how many subjects, equations, and dates did you memorize right before a test, never to use again? How many times have you remembered something 5 minutes after the teacher said stop writing, only to find out you were one mark short of the top grade? Now, does that mean remembering 5 minutes earlier would have made you more qualified for a particular job? We all have different abilities, thought processes, and genes, so why is a classroom full of individuals tested by the same means? Exams are society's methods of telling you what you're worth, but you can't let society tell you who you are, because it's the same society that says abortion is wrong, then looks down on teenage parents. The same society whose governments preach peace but endorse war, that say they believe so much in the importance of higher education and further learning. Then why increase tuition fees every single year? Tests with tests, but the finals are never final, because they never really prepare you for the final test, which is survival. And what I suggest is fairly outlandish, so I don't expect everyone to understand this. Except for the kids that knows what it feels like not to be worth anything but that D or that A, whose stories were never good enough for the English teacher, because apparently you missed out on key literal techniques, didn't follow the class plan, and the language was too informal for him to understand. Then he referenced Hamlet and Macbeth, and you'd ask him if he knew that Shakespeare was known as the innovator of slang. Or the kid in the back of the classroom is asking, why am I studying something that doesn't fuel my drive? But when confronted with a math problem, his eyes come alive. So this one is for my generation. The ones that found what they were looking for on Google, followed their dreams on Twitter, pictured their future on Instagram, and accepted destiny on Facebook. This is for my unemployed graduates, my shop assistants, and cashiers with bigger dreams. This is for my world changers and my gladiators. Because whether 42, or 68, 77, or 88, we will not let exam results determine our fate.
Ladies and gentlemen, your contestant number as the candidates brace themselves for the last category of tonight, we will now have a dance presentation from Delta Phi Delta Dance Fraternity Incorporated to Human Nature by Michael Jackson. are now in the final portion of the pageant competition of tonight, and we are now having the poise and presentation category. Let's start with contestant number one.
Oh, wow.
Contestant number one. She is wearing a white hoop gown by Panoply. Her dress is fitted at the neckline, and the bodice is decorated with jewels. It gathers at the waist and skirts out. It is the perfect combination of sheer and lace. This look is completed with a white satin pomp. Watch her as she glides the floor with grace and elegance. Ladies and gentlemen, your contestant number one. Contestant number one, what is the biggest problem facing young black women in today's society? What is the biggest problem facing young black women in today's society?
I feel that the biggest problem dealing with African American young women today is actually having the proper guidance. A lot of young black women, you know, we're stereotyped as, you know, children raising children. And a lot of kids, you know, some kids go to school just strictly to eat, not to get an education and things of that nature, and they just don't have the proper guidance. And I think that it's up to us as people to uplift our young black women in the community, in our schools, so that they can prosper and succeed in the world today. So, to answer your question, I definitely have to say that the biggest problem is guidance. Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, your contestant number one. Contestant number two. Sharkiria is bracing us with her elegance and grace in her sweetheart neckline dress. It has an Empire Stone waist, ruffled antebellum style bow gown, with accessories to accentuate her inner style. Watch her as she sparkles across the floor in her delicate gown.
I just can't stop loving you.
Contestant number two, what is the biggest problem facing young Black women in today's society? What is the biggest problem facing young Black women in today's society?
In today's society, we find that a lot of young women and young girls have low self-esteem. Very, very low self-esteem. And with that problem comes young ladies who don't believe in themselves, who don't aspire to do great things, just like the three contestants here today have aspired to become Miss Tuskegee University. So, if we work together to encourage every young lady around to be confident in themselves and to have more self-esteem, then we can have a better Tuskegee University and an even greater America, as well as great women across the world. Thank you.
So proud to say I love you.
Last but not least, we have contestant number three. Contestant number three in her regal ball gown. She is fit to be a queen wearing a strapless crisp white ball gown adorned with crystals and jewels. She floats across the floor displaying grace and poise, which is definitely expected of a Tuskegee One woman. Isn't she beautiful? Contestant number three, what is the biggest problem facing young Black women in today's society? What is the biggest problem facing young Black women in today's society?
I think the biggest problem facing women in today's society is self-confidence. I feel like as Black women, we should be strong and we should exude strength in all we do. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is your contestant number three. Thank you, ladies, and great luck on the results. You all have shown why you are deserving of the title of Miss Tuskegee University. Now it is time that we present the Miss Tuskegee University 2014-2015 Royal Court. All year, these ladies have been awarded the opportunity of representing Tuskegee University in the most high respects. And first, we have Shaniqua Bianca Jones. Shaniqua Bianca Jones is a senior biology major on the pre-medical track and a native of Brooklyn, New York. She is the proud daughter of Sobina Jones and Aubrey Best, and the eldest child of both parents. Prior to coming to Tuskegee University, Shaniqua attended Martin Luther King Junior High School, where she graduated 10% of her class.
There, she was active in several organizations, including Family, Career, and Community Leaders of America, Distributive Education Clubs of America, Martin Luther King Royal Essence Dance, and manager of the MLK Junior Lions football team. This continued on to the campus of Tuskegee University, where she participated in Student Government Association as the co-chair of an Infrastructural Integrity Committee and Executive Secretary, Naval ROTC, and the Biology Club. In her community, she volunteers at Elderly Heaven and Gail's Assisted Living because of her passion for helping others. Shaniqua is very serious about her spirituality and is a proud member of Daybreak Ministries Baptist Church, where the Reverend Weldon Seeley is a pastor. She believes that what you put into the world is what you will get back. So she lives her life filled with positivity, keeping God first and her family and friends near to her heart. Once she has received her Bachelor's of Science degree, she will move to Virginia, where she will be working as an ensign in the United States Navy. One of her favorite quotes is, "Keep your thoughts positive because your thoughts become words. Keep your words positive because your words become your behavior. Keep your behavior positive because your behavior becomes your habits. And keep your habits positive because your habits become your values." Ladies and gentlemen, Shaniqua Bianca Jones. April Baldwin. April Nicole Baldwin is a graduating senior history major hailing from the Magic City, Birmingham, Alabama. Before entering Tuskegee University, April was an active student at Jefferson County International Baccalaureate High School, where she earned both the academic and IB diplomas. She was a member of the National Honor Society, the Spanish National Honor Society, and the Scholars Bowl team, where she was elected Vice President of the Unity Club, Homecoming Queen, and Miss Tower 2010. In addition to school activities, April participated in the 2009 White Rose Debutante Cotillion, hosted by the Birmingham chapter of the Lynx Incorporated, Birmingham Civil Rights Institute's Ensemble and Legacy Youth Leadership Program. She is an active member of Tabernacle Baptist Church. When April began her journey at Tuskegee University in the fall of 2010, she joined the world-renowned Tuskegee University Golden Voices Concert Choir. April was crowned Miss Black and Gold for the Gamma Phi Chapter in the Alabama District of Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated in fall of 2011. Miss Baldwin's other leadership roles have included historian and publicist for the Golden Voices, secretary of the Tuskegee University Ambassadors, and a mathematics peer staff tutor with Tuskegee Center for Academic Excellence and Innovative Learning. This past summer, April has had the opportunity to represent Tuskegee University in Gloucester, Virginia at Holy Knoll, the historic home of Dr. Robert Roosa Moton, as a Moton Fellow. Presently, April is a tenure section leader for the Tuskegee University Golden Voices Concert Choir, a varsity member of the Honda Campus All-Stars Challenge Team, and a university ambassador. After graduation, Ms. Baldwin plans to obtain her master's degree in historic preservation and apply her torch method to preservation efforts in African American communities in her hometown of Birmingham and Tuskegee. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. April Nicole Baldwin. Tequila Celestin, Miss Tuskegee University 2014-2015. Tequila Celestin is a senior social work major from Los Angeles, California, and the proud daughter of Sakurai Profield and granddaughter of Edith Dawson. She had the distinct honor as the 85th Miss Tuskegee University for the 2014-2015 school year. She campaigned on the platform Capture the Moment, appreciating the past,
celebrating the present and preparing for the future. Throughout her campaign, Tequila's concentrated on students taking advantage of their college experiences, fortunate and unfortunate. Tequila's also incorporated performing arts and self-expression awareness. Tequila's scripture motivation during her reign is Jeremiah 29:11, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future." This scripture gives Tequila's assurance of her purpose for being Miss Tuskegee University. Tequila's has been involved in numerous extracurricular activities since her arrival at Tuskegee University. She was a member of membership chairman for the NAACP Tuskegee University chapter. She is also a freshman orientation laser leader, which requires the introduction of prospective and incoming students to Tuskegee University's values, history, and campus activities. She was a mentor with the Sound Minds Mentoring Program on campus, which helps elementary and middle school students in academic and social achievement. Tequila's was in the Marching Crimson Piper Band as a piperette dancer. Lastly, Tequila's has helped students organize and plan extracurricular events such as campaign teams, fashion shows, photo shoots, and community outreach. She plans to become a Peace Corps volunteer to help develop international and rural communities. After, she would like to become a child counselor at the Los Angeles Children's Court. Upon graduation, Tequila's plans to obtain her Master of Social Work degree and establish her own nonprofit organization for children and family counseling. Now please stand and applaud the 85th Miss Tuskegee University. Tequila's will now give us her farewell speech.
I promised myself I wasn't going to cry. Sorry, guys. Thank you. Y'all, this was an interesting year. As I look out into the crowd and I reminisce on the last year when I was a young girl standing in the backside of the stage, waiting for the results for the 2014-2015 Miss Tuskegee University. I remember a sudden rush of energy and excitement that looked in my body and that I felt in my body. Then I felt a swift change of peace. I feel the same peace standing here before you today. The peace of assurance, the peace of protection, and the peace of knowing that God is in control. I gained a desire to become Miss Tuskegee University spring semester of my freshman year. After witnessing this same pageant for the first time, I was intrigued by the poise, elegance, and glamour of the contestants and the seriousness that the student body, faculty, and staff gave towards choosing a woman to represent them as Miss Tuskegee and the brand. Yet, at that same small freshman, I did not fully understand what it meant to be a Tuskegee University woman, yet alone Miss Tuskegee University. A friend of mine recently asked me, "Tequila's, do you feel like you've changed during your progression of your reign?" And I quickly responded defensively, "Oh no, I don't change. I'm the same person since elementary school, since high school, and now." Later that day, as I was thinking of her question, I realized that yes, I was right. I did not change, but I grew. I won't lie, during my reign as Miss Tuskegee University, I experienced some overwhelming series of obstacles, disadvantages, and unfortunate events. That same time, I built my character. Well, my character was tested, and sometimes I did fail that test. But as I look back at the negative experiences, I realize that those were not intentionally to harm me. Honestly, those weren't really even about me, but they were placed in my life to help me grow. Throughout my reign, I learned the true definition of leadership. I learned that there are different types of leaders, and I learned that intention is way more important than actions. And most importantly, I learned through the experience of God knowing, I'm sorry, experience of the meaning, God will not leave me this far, or not take me this far to leave me. Now don't get me wrong, I had an amazing experience as Miss Tuskegee University. My primary goals as Miss Tuskegee was recruitment, alumni engagement, and being a spokesperson for the student body. I can say with confidence that I fulfilled my personal goals during my reign. This year, I was a walking Tuskegee University recruiting machine. Back home, I was able to speak to high school students about the importance of HBCUs and especially Tuskegee University. I traveled to elementary schools and after-school programs to speak on the importance of college and the importance of attending Tuskegee University. And I went to senior citizen homes and recreational centers to remind the elderly that there are still students who are trying to make a difference in the world and to brag on the legacy of Tuskegee University. Over my reign, I met so many alumni who offered me wisdom, their Tuskegee University testimonies, their love, and their generosity. I hold a dear appreciation for the alumni of Tuskegee University because they plant a seed and maintain the pride that we have as students for Tuskegee University. If it weren't for their story, their kindred spirits of the alumni that I encounter, I probably wouldn't be here at school. We probably all wouldn't be here today. Through my reign, I would say, if the alumni like it, then I love it. Thank you for the continued support to Tuskegee University, the student body, and overall the well-being of African Americans in higher education. And as for my students have had a faith in allowing me to represent them. The ones who believed in me that I could have been an example of a Tuskegee University woman, I did my best to represent on their behalf. Living in Adams Hall allowed me to interact with freshman ladies on a level that I didn't even imagine, from talks about boys, to campus organizations, to the morals of the university. I enjoyed my time as a mentor and a confidant. In the CAF, I was able to speak to every student, waving at everyone like I could. I learned to observe students' mannerisms and realize that we were okay as a student body and as a school. I enjoyed speaking to everyone, from the jocks to the artists, from the upcoming rap sensations on the yard to the engineer majors and to Team Brimmer. I expanded the love for my students throughout my campaign, and I hope you all notice my gratitude through my actions. Overall, my campaign experience was one of a kind. I enjoyed the football games, the convocations, speaking at open house, meeting prospective students at open house, and interacting with alumni and members of administration. But I cannot do any of this without the love of my friends and Tuskegee University. I would like to first and foremost thank God for the opportunity that I was able to share with you all. If you would have known where I was in life, you guys wouldn't believe I would be here. He has kept blessing me, and even when I didn't deserve his blessings, his grace overwhelmed my spirit. To my mom and stepfather, Charles Crowfield and Sakati Crowfield, thank you. I would also like to thank them for the lessons that they developed for my character and my self-worth. I would not be able to gain the students' trust in me to represent them as a Tuskegee University woman. Mommy, although she's not here, she's in California. Thank you for thank you for allowing me to just stay with me and giving me the opportunity to provide for me. Only the Lord knows where we have come from. and I could finally say the fruits of our labor. And the faith in God has been here with this. To my brother Benoit, thank you for your protection and concern. You have taught me unconditional love and patience. To my grandmother and my papa, thank you for your encouragement, affirmations, actions, faith, and assurance. I know that I could not do this without you. To Sister Trask, Deacon Broomfield, Sister Howard, Sister Irene, Brother John Greenfield, Sister Price, Sister Taylor, and Greater Olivet Missionary Baptist Church, I love you all and thank you for your support. Thank you to the Los Angeles Tuskegee alumni for planting that seed of pride, love, and family values in me. Without you, I would not have learned the Tuskegee etiquette and devotion. To Mr. Duncan, Miss Lynn, my Piperettes, and my MCP family, you were all my first friends, my mentors, my teachers that I met at Tuskegee University. Thank you for your bond and your loyalty. I would do anything and everything for you guys. I love you guys. To my enthusiastic laser leaders of Tuskegee University, you guys have taught me a lot about myself, how to interact with students and families. Thank you for all the laughs, intellectual conversations, and love. To my friend Ashley Hicks, thank you for all that you've done for me, from your innovative ideas to your campaign and pageantry techniques. Thank you for being a friend. To Destiny Nikki Golat, words cannot express how thankful I am for you. You came in my life from one small question in my psychology class, and I haven't let you go since. Thank you for all of you have done for me over the year and a half. You are truly one of a kind. To Karania and David, you two are something else. Thank you for the late night talks and the freaking demands of choreography. To the pre-alumni council, thank you for entrusting me to represent you and the university. You all have strengthened my love for Tuskegee University 1 week and 1 week at a conference, and I thank you for that forever. To Shania, Taylor Ray, Aisha, Haley, Bailey, Maya, and Danielle, and Chandler. Whew, look at us now. We have come a long way since Adams ground floor in Harvey Hall. We have made the most college experience with you, and I thank you guys for those memories. We have seen each other grow and mature, and now we leave to go into the world. You are all one of a kind, and I thank you for you. To Monte, Miss LaWanda Gray, Karen Stewart Moore, Saniqua Rock, Curly Hall, Betty Hammond, and Miss Camille Floyd, you all are my guardian angels. Thank you so much for helping me turn. I'm sorry. I'm gonna get through this, okay, y'all? You guys all saw a young little girl who needed your help, and you guys were willing to jump right in and save her. You showed how your love for Tuskegee University, the students, and the community. I cannot thank you enough for stepping in and stepping up when you were needed. To my advisors, Dr. Griffin, I feel like I'm officially related to you. Thank you for all of you have done for me, for your connections, your advice, your words of encouragement, just sitting and listening to me vent. Thank you for allowing me to express myself as a student and as a queen. You have given me the whole. I'm sorry. You have given me the boldness that I had that I didn't know that I had before. You shared your time, your energy, and the stress with the royal court in time, and people don't realize how important those things are until they have to experience it for themselves. I thank you from the bottom of my heart for your commitment and your vision. To Mrs. Carr, it's just you and I against the world. You are so quiet and reserved, but you are a truly powerful, humble, and loving person that I met. You are Tuskegee University. Thank you for our many attitudes, our changes in paperwork, our quick changes in ideas, runarounds, and much more that you put up with us this year. You are a counselor, you have been a counselor, a provider, and a mother when needed. I cannot thank you enough for your work this year. We both seem to have always run around campus trying to get work done, and I'm glad I was able to count on you to help me. To Dr. Harris, Dr. Green, and First Lady Johnson, Ms. Ortiz and Mr. Brown, Mr. Howe, Jessica Knight, and Oscar, thank you for guiding me throughout this year, both big and small. You guys are very intricate in my progression. I'm sorry, y'all. I know it's taking long, but I'm gonna get through it, okay? Just bear with me. Yes, this has been a drastic year, but I thank you for assisting me. To April and Bianca, thank you for putting up with me. From my unpredictable personalities to my obvious facial expressions, you have helped me keep my sanity through this rain. April, thank you for being a nurturing and loving. You helped me and Bianca all year with makeup, clothes, hair, anything we needed. We had to count on you, and I thank you for that. You have a passion for our university and your ability to keep an environment positive. Bianca, you know me more than I thought you knew me. Thank you for stepping in during troubled times. Your peaceful spirit and optimistic characteristics are one that I adore. You keep me grounded and focused on the true purpose of representing Tuskegee University. Ladies, I love you and I will miss you so much. I wish we could have more time to spend together, but I know these two ladies will be the ones that I look forward to seeing every homecoming in the future. To the Mr. Tuskegeean gentlemen, thank you for taking on the position that you did. You are a part of Royal Court history. To Carlin Hawes, Brittany Evans, Marissa and Lacey, to Tia and Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated Theta Beta Chapter, to Kalana and Krishan, to Thomas, to the California Club, to Ariana and Brittany Sherrell, to my Ebony Magazine sisters, to the Tuskegee University football team, to Kiana Gibbs, Jamon, Travis Armbrister, Kevin Thompson, Brandon Fennell, Monty, Tyler, Brian Ellis, Roger Gray, and all of my friends who have helped me throughout this year. I thank you so much for your friendship and commitment. I truly love you all, and you guys, I have not grown without you. I'm almost done. Okay, this is the last paragraph, guys. Yay. Okay, thank you guys. And as I pass on the crown to the next queen, I pray that she witnesses the same love, honor, and royalty that I'm receiving now. I encourage her, uplift her, and know that she is your queen. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2014-2015 Miss Tuskegee University, Keelan Celestin. Now the results are in. The moment that we all have been waiting for, the grand crowning of Miss Tuskegee University 2015-2016. Before we begin, I would like to express my gratitude for all of you for allowing me to serve as your mistress of ceremony. I am extremely proud of all these young ladies on the stage and behind the stage for their tremendous efforts in representing Tuskegee University. It feels so good to come home and continue to see the legacy of Miss Tuskegee University being upheld. Are you all ready? Yeah. I wasn't sure. Okay. We will start with the second attendant for the 2015-2016 academic school year. Drum roll, please. Your second attendant is Sharkiria Evans. Thank you.
your first attendant for the 2015-2016 academic school year is Nyree French.
Cash money records taking over for the 99 and the 2000. Don't you